Hello, this is Richard Wilson from the Family Office Club. Today I wanted to record a short video for you on co-GP investment structures. This is something that I didn't hear much about 7 or 8 years ago, and now I'm starting to hear about more and more often. Sometimes I meet with family offices that are worth $400 million, $500 million, and they've never heard of this concept before. Essentially, when you're running a fund and you have the GP, the manager of the fund, they're bringing in LP investors. They might have 2 investors, they might have 50 investors, but when you're the LP, you're getting charged typically the fees, whether it's a 2% management fee and a 20% profit, or with a real estate fund, there might be acquisition fees and management fees, and then a waterfall profit split, depending on the level of returns for the investor. But in any case, when you're the GP, you're managing the fund, and you're typically required to put up 10% of capital. Some GPs are more well capitalized, and they're putting up 20%, 30%, 50%. And they almost always get better returns or better fee negotiations with investors by eating more of their own cooking and doing so. But typically, sponsors or GPs are putting up 10% of the capital to do a deal. What happens many times is that the deal flow for a GP outstrips their ability to put up those 10% stakes to do more deals, especially when dealing with large deals and institutional investors or billion-dollar-plus single-family offices. So what's been happening more and more so is that some of these independent sponsors and fund managers will go to family offices and say, I will let you in on the GP side. You fund some of my 10% that I need to put up, and I'll give you a break on the fees, or I'll let you participate in the profit side of earning fees on the deal. It depends how much strategic value that family is bringing to the deal. And there's really 3 different ways that you can be treated as a co-GP investor. The first way is just being treated as a junior waterfall member. So in other words, the LP might be burdened with management fees and acquisition fees, and maybe they have to pay, you know, maybe they give up 33% of their profits after getting an 8% preferred return. That might be one example. But as a co-GP investor, you might not have to pay all of those fees, but you might be under a lower fee scaled agreement. So in other words, you might have a 20% sharing of profits after a 10% return because you're coming in as a co-GP. A second way that you can sometimes be treated in this position for, you know, a co-GP investment is really having it so it's just equal to the manager. Obviously, that's the best thing to do if you're negotiating the agreement on the investor side, where you pay absolutely no fees and you're also making money off the institutional investor or the family office LP investors. In other words, if the GP or the fund manager is taking a 33% profit share after an 8% preferred return, you would be able to participate in that. If you're adding strategic value, or you help source the deal, or you're putting up 8 of the 10% needed to do the deal, you could argue the deal wouldn't happen without you. The capital is a pretty important part, and you might be able to negotiate getting some of those fees and making money off of the LP coming into the deal that you helped make happen. If not all of it, you might want to try negotiating half of it. The other thing that sometimes happens is that the investor is only charged a performance fee and no management fee as a co-GP investor, or they might be charged no fees at all. So you might just get access to the deal, there's no management fee, there's no take of your profits after a certain amount, you just get to ride along in the deal, and you're just kind of in a sidecar, basically, and you don't get charged the LP type fees. I think this structure is excellent for family offices because many times it's when sponsors and funds get to the institutional level, they need a co-GP investor. And it's just so much smarter to be earning performance fees with your dollars or not paying fees with your investment dollars rather than paying the standard street fees for getting access to deals. So I wanted to share this co-GP idea. This is very basic. We could spend a whole webinar just on negotiating co-GP deals and different ways to structure it and different common fees that we see out there. But I wanted to keep this a really short 4-minute video just to get the quick point across. You could investigate this further if you are a single family office or angel investor and you've heard of this term and didn't know what it meant, or you were looking for ways to save money on fees this year. This is Richard Wilson coming to you from the Family Office Club. To learn more, please visit familyoffices.com, and I hope to see you at one of our events. Take care.